So in this video, we're going to have a look at the IK spline. So I'm just going to go to a side view here and just pop in a bunch of little points here just for fun. And what we'll do is we'll go up to Skeleton IK Spline Handle Tool. So we mentioned this briefly in the previous video. Just make sure this is nicely reset here. And so what we have here is root on curve, meaning that it will take the first point and lock it to the curve. We have this auto parent curve, whereupon it will parent the curve into the hierarchy. We have the auto create curve, meaning that it will create a curve for you. And then of course, auto simplify curve. Now, if I go ahead and just click this one in the other end, I've got it jumping. And this is jumping because when I created it, I told it to auto-create the curve and auto-simplify the curve. And the number of spans says 1. Now, this is always plus 3, so this would have been 4 points that it created, which wasn't quite enough actual points to be able to recreate the shape that was originally there. So if I'm just going to go ahead and undo this, apparently 4 points wasn't suitable for this. If I were to go ahead and say number 2 and click that, it's holding its form better, but it did still kind of jump a little bit. What I can do is try all the way up to my top option here and see if that does it. Just check. It's pretty close, but still not perfect. So this auto simplify curve doesn't have to actually happen. You can tell to auto create the curve and it'll create a point for every single joint on the distance here. You could also go ahead and create your own curve and tell it not to auto create the curve, in which case you click and then select the curve for this. So let's just tell it to auto create the curve without simplifying. You see there's no jumping. And if we go to this curve itself, look at its points, you can see that it's created a point at each joint location, but making sure that the curve passes through the center at each one. So the points won't be right on top of them. They're going to be setting it so that the curve mathematically will go through the centers. So that's the starting point for all of this. Now, what else have we got going on here? Well, if we go into the attribute editor, back into object mode and take a look at this, we've got a lot of the same kind of stuff that's in all of these guys. We've got a roll and twist that are in here, and we can see that even here directly. So you've got roll, which is basically the rotation of all of them at the same time. Set that back to 0. Got a twist, which will twist the end and then not the root, unless of course we tell it to root twist, in which case this will move faster than this one, but they all move. So the root twists as well, but just not as fast as this last guy. Turn that off. Then we have our enable twist controls. These twist controls allow us to create things like, let's create a locator for the root. Just duplicate that for the other end. I'm just going to grab its name, just copy that. And I have options like object up. I can set an individual object up, which means the whole thing will roll in relation to that, but the twist will still work. So if I wanted like an overall roll feature, I could do object up start and end, in which case this one's orientation left and right. In fact, let's just do that. I'll just go here and paste that. Paste again. I'll put this as a 2. And now I have orientation based on the angle of this guy's position. So it's basically an aim sort of or directional constraint. And alternatively, I can set this as object rotation up, in which case this now becomes a physical in the world rotation control, as well as this one. So you can use this control one end or the other, which is kind of cool. So those are some of the options that you have there with these guys. And let's get an example. So here's a simple tail. I've just got the geometry going on in there. And I've got a curve that I've created. And I initially had built this based off of the original geometry. And of course, wanted to get these guys into place. So if I were to just see and then middle mouse button drag, I could get them to all perfectly align across this, or I can just tell it to go ahead and figure that out. It'll automatically snap as soon as I set this up. So because I already have this curve in place and it follows the shape of the object, I will go ahead into Skeleton, IK Spline Handle Tool, and I'll tell it not to auto-create the curve. Click, click, and then go in and select the curve. And you notice that all the bones, all the joints here, have snapped to the curve itself. So if you've got a curve that specifically you want to follow, you can go ahead and put as many joints as you feel that you need, and then proceed to snap them on there. They could be anywhere in world space. They could just be sitting here. You just have them all evenly spaced, and then you go ahead and it'll snap them on directly using the hierarchy as a basis. I'm going to quickly create a layer here. And I go through the IK handle and the joints onto it. Select it. And typical use of this would be to go to create deformers and create a cluster. So I'm just grabbing these and pressing G to repeat the same command. So again, it's under Create Deformers Cluster. And you get these clusters on here. And these clusters, you can then, of course, reposition to sit outside. So I go to Cluster Handle Shape, and I'll just move that to, say, 1. And there's a little quirk in 2015 where it doesn't update right away. You just wiggle it, and it will update. And let's see how that works with regards to my geometry. So it's sitting there up above it, which is good. Do the same thing to this one. Wiggle it. This is, of course, positions in global space, so if you know exactly where you want them to be. You can work all that out. There we go. Being a little bit difficult. And I've got all these points now sitting outside. And these guys control the setup. So you can see how they work. And you can control the rig in that way. This. Go ahead and quickly assign this. I've got my tail. ready to animate. Go ahead and create the supposed body. And we'll go ahead and add press P to parent. And there we go. So another possibility that we have here is to make the curves dynamic first. So I'll show you an example of that. So in this particular case, it's the same setup. Got the joints in there, I'll skin to this. And the original curve that existed there is still here, but I've converted this to make it a dynamic curve, which would have been under and dynamics and then in hair, and then go and make the selected curves dynamic. And that will give me a new dynamic curve, which then I assigned instead of the original curve to the joints that are here. So I went ahead and click and then picked the dynamic curve instead of the original curve. If we go ahead and I'm just gonna go to shaded mode here and press play, you can see boing boing, I get a nice little dynamic curve with all the controls relating to the dynamics that are there. And because the hair system has a clump width, you can set up the collision size for these guys. So what I've done with that is established a overall clump width. And then of course we have our clump width scale, which allows us to go from the very root being the full one down to basically nothing at the end. And that's going to calculate the collisions. And of course I can just display my collision thickness here, and you can see that the collision sections, each one gets smaller and smaller, and works up fairly well. Just dynamic play that. And then I noticed that the response for this guy worked better if the collision plane here was set to vertex. I was getting quite a bit of bouncing otherwise. But this is just another example of the kind of things that you can do. And I know in XSI you have the dynamic tail, which uses soft constraints, which aren't currently available here, but this is your alternative, just making the curve dynamic instead. And then you have, with that, you get a follicle, which is what I dumped into whatever my parent object is in my rig. So this be a rig control or the root of the skeleton or whatever, that will be the control object, which will allow me to drag that around. And of course it can be set to collide with anything in my environment. So those are some options that you have with regards to the animation skeleton IK spline handle tool that you can play with. And that would be pretty good.